no deity worthy to be worshipped in truth except for God.
You are saying there is no Allah but Allah. Or else you are saying there is no God but God.
I said there's no.
That's a stupid statement.
You're not eating nothing. You're gonna be on the floor. You're gonna be.
That's a death threat. You are giving me death threats. You are giving me death threats. You are giving me death threats. So, no, you said Allah erases your sins as you touch it. You said Allah is the one who does it. Hadith doesn't say. Hadith doesn't say Allah does it. It says.
Answering the question.
You know what?
Who was the father of Muhammad?
I'm not gonna get even involved with you because you guys have no discipline. Then you guys have
Muhammad has zero discipline when he lied about my faith. Your prophet has zero discipline when he lied about my faith.
Taking the Bible with bullets or saying Bible. There is nobody doing that, but you're
that's
doing
not
it.
The point. The information in the Quran is putting the Jesus in that place.
I'm not here coming to
information
fight you or something.
In the Quran,
just
the lies in the Quran about Jesus.
You. They're not. Because basically you're doing something to play their nerves. If you just come here and do a proper debate,
where
then nobody will come and start
talking
from here and there.
So,
me, I'm just looking. I haven't even
speak. What's your name?
Because I don't know the Quran properly, so I cannot be making things against you. Because you need somebody
so
who knows exactly the Quran, what's going on.
So when he comes to speak, it's going to bring your ears.
She don't know nothing about the religion. Her religion, you don't know nothing. She don't know nothing.
Me, it's not.
If your feelings are hurt, if your feelings are hurt, come on.
Me, I'm just saying.
If your feelings are hurt because of her, then you shouldn't be here.
I'm just saying an opinion.
You shouldn't be here. This is a speaker's corner. This is a speaker's corner. Therefore, she has a right to speak. She has a right to speak.
One day you
wake up, one day you wake up, you say, I am wrong.
I am not in Saudi Arabia. I have Lord Jesus Christ found him. I am declared righteous with the blood of Lord Jesus Christ. I am correct where I stand.
Looking after her.
Why?
Because
why should I be looking after myself?
Because
other people
you do something
are
wrong.
What?
You have to respect.
What did I do wrong? Do you think is it not wrong for the lies Quran tells about Jesus?
People. Don't do that because nobody can
do you
that.
Think
with religion,
the lies about Jesus Quran tells are they good?
Why don't you teach this lesson to your Muhammad when he says, tell Jews and Christians wherever
you
find
them. That's not good to do that.
Why don't you do that?
I don't care what does look good to Muhammad or not. Muhammad has been dead. And it seems like he's dead, he's in the grave.
Anyone.
Instead of coming to her,
anyone.
Teach this lesson to Muhammad.
Why Islam doesn't respect Jesus?
In the world,
why does Islam not respect Jesus? Why does Islam not respect Jesus?
No, respect Jesus.
No.
If you respect Jesus, tell me Jesus is the Lord.
Respect
if you respect Jesus, tell me that Jesus Christ is the Lord. If you respect Jesus, tell me Jesus Christ is the Lord, Savior of the world. If you respect Jesus, tell me Jesus Christ is the Lord, the Savior of the world. Say that. Say that.
Sorry?
If you respect Jesus, tell me that Jesus Christ is the Lord, the Savior of the world.
No.
You don't respect Jesus.
Brother,
do you respect
God.
Jesus?
Oh, yeah.
Tell me Jesus Christ is the Lord,
Jesus
the Savior
is
the of the world.
Jesus is my Savior. He is my Lord, my God.
He's more than a prophet.
He is more than a prophet.
You are hurting
than
my feelings.
Bigger than me and
you are hurting
and
my feelings.
And Muhammad and
Muhammad is dead in the grave. Last 2,000 years. But Jesus is living up in heaven.
You don't know him.
Jesus is living up in heaven. He is coming back. Muhammad is not coming back. Muhammad is not coming back. Muhammad is not coming back. Jesus is coming back.
And you are going to hell.
You are going to hell. More serious than Muhammad.
Jesus
is much more superior than Muhammad.
Jesus is already with Allah.
You go into hell.
Thank you. If the place I'm gonna go, the place I'm gonna go His identified as impossible to father.
Jesus is going to heaven.
The place I am going to go, identified as impossible to father.
All Muslims are going to heaven.
Muslim, he going to heaven.
All Muslims, yes.
Muhammad is in the hell.
All of them, because even Muhammad said, I don't know where I'm going.
Jesus is the best.
Even Muhammad said, I don't know where I'm going.
Muhammad is the worst. Muhammad is the worst.
Therefore, all Muslims, they are going to hell.
How we know?
Especially the woman.
Because you are Antichrist.
Especially the woman.
Anyone who denies Jesus, his death and his resurrection, you are not going to have time with God.
Heaven. God knows.
Allah knows nothing.
What?
Allah knows nothing. But the bottom line is, one day, every knee will bow down to Lord Jesus Christ. One day, every tongue is going to confess, Jesus Christ is Lord. That's the bottom line. Anyone who rejects that, anyone who doesn't put their hope in death and resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ, or tries to add on that, I am afraid to tell you, while you can breathe in out and breathe out, repent. Otherwise, it's going to be too late.
I believe Jesus. But how me? I know that.
Christianity loves you.
Believe Jesus.
You don't believe in Jesus. You don't believe in Jesus. You don't believe in the one who gave himself on the cross for you. You don't believe in the one who was slain to save the world. You don't. You don't. You are just insulting Jesus. You are just insulting Jesus.
Why do I care? Because you are a human first.
Because Jesus cares.
You are human first. My Jesus care for you.
You know everything.
My Jesus care for you.
You know everything. Why your daughter become Muslim?
Image of God.
You know everything. Why your daughter become Muslim?
Allahu Akbar.
Why don't I become Muslim? Because I don't see anything good in Islam. Anything good in Islam.
Why?
There is nothing good in Islam.
Come on.
There is nothing good in Islam.
Come on.
The example which Muhammad is giving to Muslims are having a sex with 8 year or 9 year old girl. That's the example Muhammad is giving.
He said that he thinks Muhammad is
Muhammad is
very ugly. Oh, hello, sir. How are you? Peace of Christ be with you, brother.
Yes, bless you. I was aware. I'm not telling about
So even Quran says muta is a halal thing.
What is muta?
Muta is a halal thing.
What is muta?
Muta is a clear-cut prostitution.
Prostitution is okay?
Yes. Muta is clear-cut prostitution. That is in Islam.
What is your problem with muta?
That is in Islam.
You are giving me death threats.
Yes.
According to Islam, according to Quran, according to Muhammad, and according to Allah, muta is prostitution. Muta is prostitution. Huh? I'm the follower of Jesus Christ. Come to Jesus. Come on.
Why Jesus?
Is your loving Lord. Jesus is your living Lord. Jesus loves you. Jesus died for you.
Why would God go inside someone's belly for 9 months and then he had to come out and the blood comes out all over and then that's it, new thing.
Okay.
Why can't God be one?
Because my God is a living God.
Okay, why does God
my God is Almighty God.
God needs to go
my God is Almighty God. So basically you are saying that Allah, which is your God, cannot come to earth. Cannot come to earth.
So
you are saying that Allah, which is your God, is not a living God. Allah is a pagan god. Allah is a pagan. What does this mean? What does this mean?
There is no deity worthy to worship in truth except for Allah.
What does this mean?
No deity worthy to be worshipped in truth except for God.
Oh, so you are saying
we respect this, listen.
You are saying
why would God
there is no Allah but Allah.
You are saying there is no God but God. I said there is no.
That's a stupid statement.
Listen.
That's a stupid statement. If you are saying there is no God but God, that's a stupid statement. And if you are saying there is no Allah but Allah, that's a stupid statement. That's a stupid statement. Let me explain you why. Let me explain you why. Let me explain you why this is a stupid statement. Let me explain you why this is a stupid statement. If you say la ilaha means there is no Allah but Allah. La ilaha means there is no Allah but Allah. That's a stupid statement. But if you translate this Arabic into English, it means there is no God but God. There is no God but God. That's a stupid statement as well. That's the stupid statement as well. So that makes no sense at all. If you say La ilaha illallah, there is no Allah but Allah. In Arabic, this is a stupid statement. This is a stupid statement. This is a stupid statement. No, this is a stupid statement. And if you translate this Arabic into English, there is no God but God. This is a stupid statement as well. There is a stupid statement as well.
If you say that, automatically
if Muslims are mixing Arabic into English, that's a stupid of them also. That is a stupid for them also.
They can mix with English.
Yeah, they are mixing English and Arabic together.
Anyone who says La ilaha,
there is no God but Allah. This is there is no God but Allah.
It means there is no deity worthy to be worshipped.
This is a stupid statement as well.
Sir, that's not, you know, if you are Arabic speaker, you know that's not true.
No.
Sir, yeah, in that case, you've been told lies. That's not true.
You don't understand Arabic. Okay, where are you from?
Turkey.
You don't know Arabic. Did you go to Arabic? Teach me about Arabic.
No, what you said, you lied.
Did you go to Arabic school?
What you said, you simply lied, sir. It's not about magical Arabic. What you said is a lie, and you are trying to justify that.
There is no God but God. Worthy to be worshipped in truth except Allah.
Then why do you worship the shin of Allah? Why do you worship the black stone?
We don't worship black stone.
You don't worship black stone? Don't you kiss the black stone?
I hate that Allah.
Just because someone
kisses
something.
Don't you kiss the black stone? No one worships it. Why do you kiss the black stone?
Because Allah told us.
So why?
Because Allah told us. It removes our
sins. Where is it? So if the black stone removes your sin, black stone needs to know what you sin, okay? Listen. Put your brain together, listen. So black stone must be know what are your sins. And black stone must remember what your sins. And black stone is powerful to erase your sins. How can black stone and the attributes of Allah to forgive your sins?
Black stone has no power. It has no power.
Then why do you kiss it?
Allah knows if we kissed it, and He's the one that's going to remove
it. It doesn't say Allah. Open it up.
Everything.
Open it up.
Who has a Jesus Christ?
Open it up.
Who has a Jesus Christ?
Adafdi. Does anyone have deal?
Open it up.
Who has a Jesus Christ? Don't even
tell me. Does anyone have deal? Open. Get her.
Who has a Jesus Christ? Even Allah. Who has a Jesus Christ?
Sir, I'm waiting for the hadith.
What kind of Allah is it?
Is your friend looking for the hadith?
You say Allah ilaha illallah, you be Muslim.
You say Allah ilaha illallah. Am I? Am I? I hate that Allah. I hate that idol Allah. How can I be a Muslim? How can I be a Muslim? I hate that Allah. I hate that Allah. You know why? You know why I hate that Allah? Because that Allah is teaching that muta is a halal thing. That Allah is saying that prostitution is a halal thing. That Allah is saying halala is a halal thing. Come on. Halala. Allah is saying halala is a halal thing. Halala is a halal thing. You don't know? Go ask your imam. Ask your imam. If you don't know halala, even Allah says that female genital mutilation is a halal thing. Yeah. Female genital mutilation is a halal thing.
Look, is that true? Is that you true? Have to pay him more. Is that true? Because you change all the time.
Even Allah says, Allah says in Quran and Hadith that female genital mutilation is a halal thing. Halal is a halal thing. Prostitution is a halal thing. So what kind of Allah is it? What kind of Allah is it? Let me show you Allah. Let me show you Allah here. Ah yes, this is Allah here. You know what? Oh, he has taken my Allah. He has taken my Allah. So
ask Allah, you
come on, get my Allah here. Come on, get my Allah here. Come on, get my Allah here.
Ask him, he's coming.
You know why?
Ask him, come in.
You know why this Allah?
Why?
Why this Allah is a stone? Why this Allah is stone? Because this Allah does not have spirit. Allah is not a spirit. That's why this Allah is a stone. That's why this Allah is stone. That Allah is not a living God. That Allah is a stone. Therefore, you need a living God. You need a living God. Not stone, not idol. Don't worship idol. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus, who is a living God.
Listen. When you say I believe
in, I am trying to figure out.
Okay.
Give time to your brother. Okay. Your brother until get the hadith. After that we continue, sir. Let's deal with the one topic. No. Right now I want to see the hadith where it says when you kiss the black stone, Allah is the one who forgives.
How is he gonna know? Your tongue is gonna know. Sir, God knows.
Sir.
It's not your tongue that has the power.
Get the hadith. Get the hadith.
Why not get the hadith?
Get the hadith.
Umar ibn Khattab.
Get the hadith. No. Get the hadith.
I'm getting the hadith. Right,
the hadith which says, when you kiss the black stone, Allah is the one who forgives your sins. Yeah, that's fine. Okay. No need to get excited. Let's find the hadith and then talk about it.
Therefore, you need a living God. You need a living God. Black stone, not
a reader. Don't talk because she's paying every day. She pays.
So now Muslims coming again, that they are taking my freedom of speech away by taking people away from me.
To be here to say that. Don't say that. If you...
I'm waiting for the hadith, sir.
She pays. She can't change her. She do nothing about it. She don't know anything about religion. Please come. Don't say.
What happened to the hadith, sir? What happened to the hadith? I'm not Muhammad.
She's the same in her face.
All if you translate,
she's the same.
Did Jesus tell you to do
this? Sir, give me the hadith.
Did Jesus tell you to do this?
Give me the hadith.
Did Jesus tell you
give me the hadith.
No, no, no. Jesus told you to...
Don't play that game you're... now. You know that hadith does not exist. Just give me the hadith and then we talk about it.
You know Jesus would get onto you if he does.
Sir, give me the hadith.
You know Jesus.
Give me the hadith.
Wait, the hadith for what?
Hadith where your brother claimed that when you kiss the black stone, Allah is the one who forgives your sins. I am looking for that hadith.
Allah controls everything. Why do I need to get a verse that explains that?
Give me the hadith. Because you know you lied. You know you lied.
Where's your Allah, God.
Where's your Brexit suit?
Sometimes I don't wear it all the time. I'm a bit hot tonight.
Yeah.
I didn't consider wearing it. I'm glad I haven't because it's too bloody hot.
Anyway, brother,
he's hiding. Allah has become hungry. Yeah, according to Islamic sources, that's very basic.
James O'Brien was right, wasn't he?
So what did he say?
Yeah, he said all this happened.
Touching the black stone is one of the things by means which Allah expiates your sins. This narrative was narrated in Bukhari.
Can I touch it?
This is Bukhari.
But is
so don't get me
wrong. No. Bukhari, volume what?
Bukhari 4987.
Bukhari
4987. Read it.
What does it say?
Do you have eyes? Read it.
No.
Read it.
Just a moment. What does it say?
Read it. It says,
let me find it from here.
Listen. Touching the stone.
Wait.
By one of the means. One of the means which Allah expiates for sins. It was narrated.
Let me see. This is number 959.
Yeah.
Ibn Umar was clinking on the two corners in the manner that I had not seen any of the companions of Prophet doing. So I did. I said, "Oh Abu Abdurrahman, you are clinking on the two corners in the manner that I have not seen any companions of Prophet clinging." So he said, "I do this because I heard." I am reading the whole thing. I'm reading the whole thing. Don't lie. Okay.
Read it.
I do this because I heard Messenger of Allah saying, touching them atones for your sins. And I heard him saying, whoever performs tawaf around this house 7 times and keeps track of it, then it is as if he freed a slave. And I heard him saying, 1 foot is not put down, no another erased, except Allah removes a sin from him and records a good merit for him.
So the hadith about the stone is here, where you read it.
Touching them atones for your sins. So my question was to you. You said, when you kiss the black stone, it is Allah who forgives. Okay? So can you please point out where is in this hadith? That's what it says. Because this hadith simply goes against what you said.
Allah expects the sins.
No, it doesn't say Allah. It doesn't say Allah.
Touching it.
It doesn't say Allah.
So who else is gonna forgive your sins?
James from the block.
James from the block is gonna forgive
black
my sins.
Blackstone is doing that. It doesn't say Allah.
No. Touching the stone.
So you misrepresented your Islamic sources. You misrepresented your Islamic sources.
I said touching it atones for your sins.
No, you said Allah erases your sins as you touch it. You said Allah is the one who does it. Hadith doesn't say. Hadith doesn't say Allah does it. It says, I do this.
If it's not Allah, who else is going to do it?
Guys, if I read it second time, if I read it third time, it is the same thing. But let me read it again. I don't know everything. I'm not God. I don't know everything.
Who is going to touch it other than Allah? Ya Allah.
Is Allah is kissing the black stone? Why Allah is touching the black stone?
Who is going to forgive your sins? Who is going to forgive your sins other than Allah?
Black stone is... If you are kissing the black stone,
Even the English don't understand.
She's confused because they worship the creation. They don't worship the creator. Let her read it again.
I worship the creator. Don't lie about me, sir. You are causing stress. You are causing stress and putting my life in danger right now. So, black stone is the one who erases. Black stone is the one who erases your sins. If I read it from the top to bottom, it is the same thing. Listen, have a respect here.
Listen.
Umar was clinging on the two corners. So I said to Abu Abdurrahman, you are claiming all the true Qurans in a manner that I have not seen. That's the hadith says, that I have not seen any of the companions of the Prophet cleaning. So he said, I do it because I heard the Messenger of Allah saying, touching them atones for sins. It's not, if you touch them, Allah is going to erase your sins. Touching it is atoning for your sins. And I heard him saying, whoever performs tawaf around his house 7 times and keeps track of it, then it is as he freed a slave. Then I heard him saying, 1 foot is not put down, nor another raised except what Allah removes a sin from
Allah
who records, who records,
Allah removes the sin. Read again. Allah removes the sin
from your ears together. Be faithful to your hadith and then tell me, and then tell me, how come Blackstone is forgiving your sins?
He just said that Allah forgives the sin from him.
It doesn't say. It doesn't say. It doesn't say.
Stop lying now.
It says touching them. Touching them atones for your sins.
Yeah, yeah, and it goes when it goes down, and you just said that. I
it
don't know what
it says.
Messenger of
no,
Allah
another
saying.
Another raised except that Allah removes a sin from him and rewards a good deeds merit for him. You just said it. Isn't
Allah
the same
kissing the black stone what? Is atoning your sins.
When did I say that? Stop.
That's what Umar is explaining. You just,
huh?
That's what Umar is explaining.
I don't care.
Are you better than
him.
Umar? You don't. You can't. You don't care about Umar.
Oh, Umar, huh?
You don't care about
Umar.
I don't
mean about the other guy. I don't know.
Khalid,
yeah, I know.
Umar.
I thought he's talking about the other guy. I thought he's talking about what?
Where did the black stone come from?
That's a different discussion. That's a different discussion. This one discussion. He said, just said it in the same hadith. Look at it. Why are you looking at me? Look
I'm
at
trying
it.
To listen to you, sir.
Look
I want to see how you are going to put
shame. I've heard a different story. But
no, another. In
my
the
question
same,
to
know,
him,
in the same
my
hadith.
Question is, how come touching the black stone, how come, sorry, how come touching the black stone, how come kissing the black stone erases your sins?
Yeah, he just said it right here. He just said it right
yeah.
here.
This it like, says, Allah says, touching them atones for
yeah.
sins.
Yeah, and explains
how
it down
come,
here.
How come black stone knows who you
I
are? What are your sins and what have you done?
Don't listen, she doesn't let me speak. She doesn't let
don't
me speak.
Don't play crying games.
I'm trying to explain. She's trying to explain.
You came back?
When you touch the black stone, then he erased
it. Listen, you're right here. The black stone's right here. But he's explaining who removes the sins and who added the deeds. It's just here. Look, read it. No another raised except that Allah removes the sin from him and records a good deed merit for him. That's explaining.
Sir,
explaining who removes
why do
the
you
sin.
Kiss the black stone if Allah is the one who is removing the sin?
Because is that is it you
if Allah is the one
the stone,
why are you appreciating the stone which is the symbolizer of the sin of
from heaven? It's
no,
from heaven.
It was from heaven, it came down as white as milk. And the sins of Adam turn it to black. It's a symbolizer of the sin. So
yeah.
Why do you, if Allah is the one who forgives sins, who atones for the sins, why do you kiss the black stone?
Because it's from Allah. It's from Allah.
Allah is like an order from Allah. Allah
because you're showing
to
your effort. You're saying, yeah, chef, listen. You're going all the way from the UK to touch the black stone. That's showing your effort. What?
Exactly.
You wear your cross every single day. We go once or twice to touch
one.
It. You wear your cross every
effort
single day.
One.
You worship your cross.
Effort
you
for
worship
one.
The cross.
You worship the cross.
Effort
you worship
for
the cross.
One.
Why
I worship the one
the
who died on the cross.
You worship the cross.
I worship the one who died on the cross.
Exactly.
So now.
We worship the one who died.
Why would you worship someone that died?
Sir,
why would you worship someone that died?
Exactly.
If that was the case, you wouldn't kiss it.
Yeah, but we're talking about.
If Allah is the one who forgives it, you wouldn't kiss it.
We're talking about why do you worship a guy who just died? You just said it.
He died and he conquered the grave. Now, answer the question. Answer the question. Why do you kiss the black stone? That's the first thing. And according to you, Jesus didn't even die. Do you believe Jesus died?
No, just said it.
Do you believe Jesus died?
No, I don't.
You don't. So, don't. So what
no,
does? Jesus is still alive. He is on the throne. Allah rules and reigns. Jesus is with Allah. Now, tell me about the French kiss with the black stone. Tell me about the French kiss about the black stone. I don't kiss this. I don't kiss the cross. That cross is going to remove my sin. You kiss the black stone. That black stone is going to remove your sins.
Yeah, why do you kiss the cross then? Why do you kiss it?
You didn't listen. You didn't listen. You didn't listen.
You
didn't listen.
I didn't listen.
So, you kiss the black stone so that black stone removes your sins.
No, the black stone. Allah removes
It doesn't say, Hadi, it doesn't say.
The black stone. It does say.
It doesn't say. It doesn't say. It is here. It doesn't say. It doesn't say.
Wait, watching this.
Don't touch my phone. You don't need to hold it. You don't need to. Just read it. Read it. He's not. He's not expert on it. Just read it.
Bring it closer.
Sir, read it. Read the part where it says touching them atoms for your sins. Read the part. I'll help you. Touching, touching, them, them, atoms, atones, for, for, sins, sins.
Allah said, it says it at the top.
Allah is saying, I'm sorry that your Allah is lying.
Look, listen, are you going to let me see it until explain it?
Explain it.
Okay, come. This is it. The messenger of Allah says, touching the stone, touching them atones for the sins. It's a long hadith, so I'm going to bring it down because it's a long hadith. No another raises except Allah removes a sin from him or record a good deed for him.
So touching the black stone, kissing the black stone, doing French kiss with the black stone atones for your sins. Correct?
Allah removes the sins from him.
So if Allah removes the sin, why do you at the first place need to kiss or have French kiss with the black stone? Allah, can't Allah do it by himself?
Of course he can.
Then why Allah is telling you to kiss the black stone so black stone atones for your sins?
The black stone is a gift from Allah.
What kind of gift is it? Black stone is the symbolizing of the sin. I'm listening. You are not just making any sense. Don't cry to me. Don't cry. How can black stone atone for your sins?
She's keep talking over me. She doesn't let me explain my viewpoint.
Exactly.
Okay, you're going to be quiet. Are you going to cut me again?
No, good.
When you kiss the black stone, it's a gift from Allah. It's a gift from Allah, the black stone. When you kiss it, you're giving it a value. You're giving it a value. When you kiss something, when you kiss your mother, you value your mother, you love your mother. When you kiss the stone, you value the stone, it's a gift from Allah. So Allah removes the sin from you and adds a good deed. That's exactly.
So, when you kiss your mom, your mom doesn't atone for your sin. When you kiss your son doesn't atone for your sin. But when you kiss the black stone is the one which atones for your sins. Stop committing shirk, Muslim people. Allah is gonna cook you. Allah is gonna make barbecue from you in hell. Give it up. Give it up. Only one who can forgive your sins, Lord Jesus Christ. Only one who atoned for your sins is Lord Jesus Christ. He did that with his death and his resurrection. Give it up. Turn to Lord Jesus Christ.
I was about to say to them, they said, you are a Muslim because I said, La ilaha illallah. And I said, tell me the translation of La ilaha illallah. Okay. If you say La ilaha illallah in Arabic, then you have to say that there is no Allah but Allah. Because Arabic will go with Arabic. Or if you translate this Arabic into English, then there is no God but God. That is a stupid statement as well. And Arabic statement as well. But because Muslims, they mix up. They mixing Arabic in English. They say, there is no God but Allah. That is a foolishness as well. That is a foolishness as well. Yes. Because this Allah does not have a spirit. This Allah is not a spirit. So Allah is not a spirit. Therefore, Allah cannot grab, Allah cannot walk, Allah cannot talk, Allah cannot eat, Allah cannot... No, he can't sit down. So he is an idol.
Allah does become hungry.
And he becomes hungry.
Huh?
Allah becomes hungry.
Because...
So he's not self-sufficient.
Huh?
So Allah becomes hungry?
Yeah. That's what Hatun says. according to me, Allah is nothing but an idol. Idol of Makkah. You know why?
160 idols?
You know why?
Why, uncle?
Because Abdullah was the father of Muhammad. Abdullah was the father of Muhammad. What does Abdullah mean? What does Abdullah mean? Come on. What does Abdullah mean? The slave of Allah. Yeah? Slave of Allah. Abdullah was the father of Muhammad, means the slave of Allah. The slave of Allah was born in pagan family. He lived as a pagan. He worshipped pagan Allah. He died as a pagan. So which Allah servant he was? He was the servant of pagan Allah.
Perfect.
Yeah, he was the servant of pagan Allah. Therefore, that same Allah is driven in Islam. That pagan Allah is in Islam. Muhammad's Allah, Muhammad's father's Allah. Muhammad's father's Allah is in Islam. So Allah is nothing more than a pagan god. Idol.
No.
I think Muhammad himself has destroyed him. Come here, let's talk. Come to Jesus. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. Muhammad is dead. Jesus is coming back. Muhammad is not coming back. Only Jesus is coming back. Yes. In the Bible. Bible is my text message.
Yeah? That's right. I agree.
Bible is my text message.
Today is Sunday, and it's Christian Day. Why are Muslims preaching here today on a Sunday? They must be Christian.
Excellent. Excellent.
They must be Christian.
Yes.